Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Lauren Grills.
And I'm Steve Fury.
And we've got a jam-packed show this week. Steve will be talking about everything from the end of the fire danger period to election enrolments. First up, though, the agenda for the April Council meeting has just been posted.
Yes, Lauren. Now available from our website is the agenda for the council meeting on the 20th of April. Some of the main decisions going to council include the adoption of the Natural Environment Strategy for 2016 to 2026. It's a 10-year plan. The Economic Development Strategy for 2015 to 2020 and the Sports and Active Recreation Needs Assessment. There's also the service and fees charges for the next financial year, which ties into the release of the 2016-17 draft budget.
The draft budget is also available for download, and we encourage community members to have a look at this, as we're going to be holding some feedback and Q&A sessions in the coming weeks, both in person and online.
This draft budget has been prepared to fit within the cap of an average rate rise of 2.5% and includes services and support for assets totaling $76 million. An amount of $58 million will be for delivering services and initiatives, while the Capital Works program will total $15.8 million this year.
Operating costs have been maintained at last year's level, which equates to a real reduction of $1.9 million. So that's a zero increase in employee operating costs, materials and services. There are loans of just over $2.9 million for projects like the Priority Bike Network, Cowes Revitalisation Projects, Bass Valley Children's Centre and the Pioneer Bay Drainage Strategy. For more details, head to basscoast.vic.gov.au/budget or grab a copy of the draft budget from one of our customer service centres.
Hello, and we've had some great feedback from last year's aged and disability and our planned activity group client satisfaction surveys. The results are the best they've ever been.
The survey includes home care, personal care, respite care and home maintenance, and it showed a 99% satisfaction rate with the services council provides and a 100% satisfaction rate with community care workers.
The results also showed a 97% satisfaction rating with the home maintenance officers and assessment and office staff. So their work helps aged and disability clients stay independent and often allows them to stay in their home longer. And it's such a good acknowledgement for the work they do.
It sure is, Steve. And moving on from home carers to elections. At the time we are recording this, the Minister for Local Government, Natalie Hutchins, still hasn't made a decision about what the ward boundaries will look like in Bass Coast for the local government elections in October. And she's also yet to decide how many councillors will be in the new ward structure.
It won't be far away though, Lauren, as representation reviews like this have to be finished within 6 months of an election, so she has only until Friday the 22nd of April to announce her decision, and it's of course a great reminder for everyone to check their electoral enrolment.
It's really easy to check or update your enrolment details at the Victorian Electoral Commission website, that's vec.vic.gov.au, and if you're having an 18th birthday before the 26th of August, you can enrol to vote for the first time in the local government elections. If you turn 18 after the 26th of August, I'm afraid you'll have to wait to vote in the next local government elections in 2020. Of course, in the meantime, make sure that you enrol to vote for state and federal elections.
Thanks, Lauren. The Country Fire Authority has declared that the fire danger period is now over. Bass Coast CFA Operations Officer Paul Summons said they've reviewed the weather, the rainfall figures, grass growth and how dry the vegetation is in the Bass Coast area. And from this, they've said that the fire danger period and its restrictions can end, which happened on Monday just this week.
Of course, Council's local laws still apply to burning off, so if you need to, please check out our burning off guidelines, which are available on our website at basscoast.vic.gov.au/burning off. Or at any of our customer service centres, or just give us a call if you're not sure. There are some road and drainage works underway that drivers might need to be aware of. We're currently realigning the pedestrian crossing in Graham Street, Wonthaggi, just outside Rose Lodge Aged Care. So while there might be some minor traffic delays, the crossing will end up being much safer.
Works in Hagelthorne Street, Wonthaggi, will see it fully closed between Bailey Street East and Bilson Street from this Monday, the 11th of April, until the middle of May, and that's dependent on the weather. The result will be improved safety at this intersection and by helping control the traffic speed. You can see more details on these works and others that are soon to start or that have just been completed at basscoast.vic.gov.au/projects.
If you're a cyclist, there's some great news out of Public Transport Victoria. Bass Coast is one of a few areas where bike racks on buses will be trialled. From this week, cyclists will be encouraged to get on board and bus your bike on a route between Cowes and Wonthaggi. The racks can only fit two bikes at a time and are available on a first-come, first-served basis, so allow extra time for your journey.
If you're going to take your bike on the bus, just make sure that before the bus arrives, any attached items like bottles and pumps have been removed, as you'll need to take these on board with you. Also, your bike can't have any front-mounted accessories or, you know, anything that's going to obstruct the driver's view.
The trial is running for the next 12 months, so give it a try. Before we go, there's a few events on this weekend, including the WD40 Phillip Island Super Sprint V8 Supercars at the Phillip Island Circuit, and the Wonthaggi Business Association is hosting a business breakfast titled Succeeding on the Web.
And on this Sunday, this year's Kernot Grantville Fire Brigade 4x4 and Ute Show and Shine is on. So for more details on these and other events, head over to our calendar of events at basscoast.vic.gov.au/events.
Thanks, Stephen. That's all we've got time for this week. If you need more information or have any questions about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 BCoast. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 2211. You can also follow us or contact us on Facebook at facebook.com/Bass Coast Shire or on Twitter on @BassCoast. Catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au.